This week on Maker Update, an LED screen guitar, the Pi 3 Model A Plus, VLC for Raspbian, Kodak's 3D printer, a pizza slice stream controller, making litho panes, and testing servos. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome to another Maker Update. I hope everyone's doing well as we coast into December. It's a big show today with a lot to cover, so let's get started with the project of the week. Over on SparkFun, Andy England posted his update to his animated LED guitar project. In part one, he shows you how the guitar was modified with LEDs and fiber optics. In part two, he talks about how he turned those LEDs into a video screen. What's special about the way he's doing this is he's using an industry standard lighting control protocol called DMX and sending the visuals over Wi-Fi. This allows him to use VJ software to play with the visuals in real time and maybe even respond to what he's playing. It looks incredible. It's time for some news. I was off last week, so I didn't get a chance to catch you up on the new Raspberry Pi board that was announced. This is the Pi 3 Model A Plus. It's a slightly smaller footprint than the common B Plus model, but now has many of the same specs, including the processor and built-in Wi-Fi. You sacrifice an Ethernet port and you only have a single USB port, but you save $10 over the cost of a Pi B Plus without sacrificing performance like you would with a Pi Zero. It's available now for 25 bucks. The Pi Foundation also announced an update to their Raspbian operating system. The update includes a fully hardware accelerated version of the VLC media player, making it easier to play audio and video files from the desktop interface. The update also includes the latest version of the Thonny editor for coding in Python. In 3D printing news, Kodak has announced the availability of their own 3D printer called the Kodak Portrait. The printer is priced at $3,499 and features dual 1.75mm extruders. And while the hardware isn't anything we haven't seen before, the selling point is their IT-compliant 3D cloud software for managing files over a network, so it might be a good fit for a business or a college lab. I have some more projects to share on Instructables. Broken Antler Workshop has a great guide up on making this video stream controller box shaped like a slice of pizza. The project is essentially a demonstration on how to use an Arduino Pro Micro to act as an HID keyboard device. Each of the arcade buttons are defined as different hotkeys on the keyboard in the Arduino code. You hook up this pizza slice to your computer over USB, and your computer will see it as a keyboard. I also like this guide by Dave Astles on Adafruit showing you how to make your own servo testing rig. His design uses an Adafruit featherboard, a small OLED screen, a logic level shifter, and a rotary encoder. With it, you can dial in a specific angle or define a range for the servo to sweep through. The code is written in CircuitPython, and you can find cheaper ways to test the servo, but this one is pretty nice, and the readout and features make it pretty useful. I have a bunch of tips to share. First, Gareth Branwyn's latest Tips of the Week column covers prop making with foil and duct tape, making the most from a cheap airbrush, and more ideas on reusing old 3D printer filament spools. Last week, I experimented with 3D printing images using the lithopane technique, where light and dark areas are created using thicker or thinner buildup of plastic. I came across a free site called Image to Lithopane that makes it easy to try out for yourself. Jimmy DiResta has two new tips videos out. One is on using a reciprocating saw, and the other is for using a circular saw. Both are full of great advice. The annual desktop fabrication issue of Make Magazine is out. It's always one of my favorites, full of reviews and info on 3D printers, laser cutters, and CNC routers. I recommend picking up a copy. Bob Claggett has a new video out on how to use a multimeter. These things still confuse me, so it always helps to have them explained from another perspective. Adafruit has a new soil moisture sensor out called the Stemma Soil Sensor. It's $7.50, and it's a capacitive sensor instead of the more common resistive style. Best of all, Lady Ada herself writes up about why capacitive is the way to go and why those forked metal-plated sensors don't hold up. Through the Adafruit blog, I learned about a site called DIYWalkers.com. If you ever wanted to build your own Strand B-style linkage system for a small robot or a giant kinetic art piece, this site has tons of examples and advice and even some software for simulating your designs. It's a great nerdy rabbit hole to fall into. And if you're looking for a useful, inexpensive servo tester to play with, I've got a video up on the Cool Tools channel looking at a $10 option from Amazon. It's a quick way to prototype with servos without getting hung up on code and microcontrollers. Maker Faires, we have two this weekend, including Los Angeles and Ogaki, Japan. If one's near you, go check it out or head to makerfair.com to find out when your local fair is happening. All right, and that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, or leave a comment. You can get on the Maker Update email list to get show notes emailed out to you automatically every week with a few bonus projects thrown in. And a huge thanks to my patrons on Patreon who make it possible for me to do this show without going broke. If you appreciate me being out here every week, gathering up all the good stuff to show you, consider becoming a patron for as little as $1 a month. All right? Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week.